I often find my way out here, even when it's cold. In fact, early on in quarantine this past winter, when there was still snow on the ground, we grabbed up our kids, some hot chocolate and marshmallows, some fruit snacks, a couple sleds, and the dog, jumped in the car and just went to look for a quiet place. We spent the afternoon sliding and playing, tossing marshmallows in the air. The dog would try to jump and intercept them, and the kids built little snow caves to freeze their fruit snacks. It was awesome. Something really recalibrating, resetting about it. There's something about being out and away from everything else that just kind of puts things in perspective. It's the mountains for me, maybe for you. It's just sinking into the right chair at the right time of day. For some, maybe it's a beach staring out over the ocean or just the right spot next to the pool in the sun. Lots of places to do this, but for me, it's the mountains. Being out here and recognizing that for all the craziness, the chaos that might be in my life, the long to-do list, the schedule, the stress, the hustle, the things asking for attention, there's things out here that pay no mind to that. Even though all that's happening down in the valley, trees here, still growing. Rocks, still where they were the last time I was here. The patterns of life, the things that often happen here, always happen here, just they continue with complete disregard to all of the other things going on somewhere else. And in that, for me, there's this right sizing of all the emotion, of all the stress, of the anxiety, the things that kind of find their way in. The to-do list that's front page news down there is little more than a byline up here. That as true as all the things that I struggle with or face anywhere else, giant trees and looming cliffs pay no mind to any of those things. And it resets those things always being true. And stepping into those, being surrounded by those, immersed in those, brings a peace, a stillness, a recalibrating in me that puts things into perspective. There's something about Christmas that makes these moments that are full of peace, a quiet settledness, they just matter more. We look forward to them. We imagine them. We picture things playing out like that. Like a moment sitting down with our family to read through the Christmas story. And even as we read through the Christmas story in Luke chapter 2, I imagine it playing out with a quiet, a stillness, right? Silent night and all that. In verse 6 of Luke chapter 2, it just says so matter-of-factly, while they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to her first child, a son. She wrapped him snugly in strips of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no lodging available for them. This picture of calm and quiet, I don't know if it's the song, maybe it's the nativities that we arrange everywhere on mantles with little figurines arranged just perfectly, quietly, caught in a stillness that we just kind of long for. In my hometown, we actually, around Christmas, there was this tradition for many years of setting up what's called a live nativity, where real people, teenagers, would put on real costumes and be surrounded by real animals and just then freeze in this perfect, like try to stay as still and as quietly arranged as possible in this life-size nativity so that people could walk by quietly in a hushed atmosphere, just kind of take in the moment. It was always funny though, because it never quite worked. Inevitably, there would be a donkey wander off and someone would have to go chasing them, or Joseph, 17-year-old Joseph, would lock his knees and then totally pass out in the middle of the nativity, or nothing says peace on earth quite like a 20th century farmer barreling his way into the scene to capture a rogue sheep almost ready to take out two angels. Life's never quite as tidy as the still photo version of a nativity. Our lives really play out way more in a video kind of format. But still, there's something in us that longs for that kind of peace. Maybe not always on the outside, but at least somewhere in us. A peace and a settledness that allows us to navigate the many challenges and things that inevitably enter our lives. God actually invites us to this kind of life with a settled, calm, and inner world. Like, this is actually what Jesus lived out. As chaotic and crazy as his birth absolutely was, like, we can sing Silent Night all day long, but listen, I was at the birth of all four of my kids. There was nothing silent about it. Not all was calm. in Jesus' life quickly, even in what was surely to be a crazy birth with nowhere to stay and people coming to visit, all these things, it would soon be followed by a trip as refugees to another land, right? He would return to a town nearby, but likely would have lost his father somewhere in his adolescence and then lived a life somewhat as an outcast, living so differently than everyone else, never quite fitting in. From the Bible, we actually know the most about the last 3 years of his life, but even then, there was so much going on. He was surrounded by so much change and interaction and challenge. I mean, he could debate and argue with the sharpest of thinkers and challenge their thinking. He performed miracle after miracle. There were crowds that were ready one day to make him king and to throw him off a cliff the next day. Even toward the end of his life, navigating a trial that was completely false and being abandoned by most of the people that had walked through life with him, he navigated constant change. But even though it was chaotic and challenging around him, there was a way in which he navigated life with a settled inner peace, this steadiness from which he had strength to navigate all that was going on around him. And God invites us to the exact same thing. In relying on things that are so true, no matter what happens around us, things that are still true even when everything else changed, God can bring a stillness into us. Throughout Jesus' life, things were constantly changing. But still, in the midst of all of that, he could return to a steadiness and a peace. No matter how much changed or how much chaos happened around him, it never made its way in him. And God invites us to that kind of life. No matter what kind of craziness and chaos might be around us, there's a stillness inside us that can remain because there are things that remain true no matter what, that will never change, that will still be true no matter what changes ahead. Christmas is a reminder of that. December 25th is coming one way or the other. Right? This Christmas may look different than many before it, but still, Christmas comes around. The calendar turns, the dates arrive, and we still celebrate the birth of Jesus. And in the midst of that, all the things that he made true for us that will never, ever change. For all of us who would place our trust in him and live and rest and remain and settle into these truths, we can find a stillness and a peace. Like the fact that no matter what, he will always be with us. Christmas is the story of him showing up to be with us, making a way in his death, burial, and resurrection for us to always be with him. And there's nothing that can change that. In Romans chapter 8, we're reminded there's no power anywhere. There's nothing in all of creation would ever be able to separate us from the love of God that has been revealed. And we celebrate at Christmas in Christ Jesus. When we make him our Lord, when we follow him, when we trust him, he's with us and he's for us. He's not gonna give up on us and he's not gonna run out of power, right? No matter how much may change around us, no matter what other things we may have relied on, no matter what may have brought comfort or peace in the past that may have changed, God doesn't change. He didn't show up with strength in our life only to run out in our greatest time of need. In Romans 8:11, it says, the Spirit of God who raised Jesus from the dead, that level of power, the Spirit of God that raised Jesus from the dead lives in us when we trust him. And just as God raised Christ Jesus from the dead, he will give life to us by the Spirit living in us. No matter what's around us, he is in us. And that can create a settled peace, a confidence, a stillness, no matter what's around us. And he's always working for our good. No matter what changed, God is so strong. No matter what happens, he can make good come from all things. His goodness to everyone who trusts him has not changed. He still dreams, desires, hopes, and works for good in all of our lives when we entrust ourselves to him. Jesus can make all of this and more come true in our lives when we place our trust in him. When we recognize and live in the things that are still true because God says they're true, we can live with a stillness in our lives. Now, I get it that we've lived in a life where like everything has changed. In 2020, things that we never thought would change have changed. Things as simple and commonplace as going to school, hugging someone you care about, open restaurants, all kinds of things have changed, even things like relationships and jobs. And sometimes when some things change in our life, we start to think maybe everything changes in our life. But there are things that are true and will never change. What God says is true. God's character, what he's done for us, what he's accomplished in Jesus, these things never, ever change. And when we have those, when we rest on those, we can live a life marked by peace, by a settledness, a stillness inside us, even when things around us are not still and quiet and settled. Christmas is a great time to start asking a question. How much peace and stillness are we experiencing? How are we doing at remembering and resting in what God says is true? Are we finding the kind of peace that he has invited us to? Now, I know there's gonna be like scrambling through all the torn up wrapping paper looking for scissors and batteries. There's gonna be hustles to make meals and clean them up and all kinds of noise and things going on around us. But even in the midst of that, in our inner world, are we able to step back and experience a peace and a settledness, even when there may be ambiguity and questions and excitement and all the things around us? Jesus' life shows us the way to this as well. He modeled a way toward peace. Over and over through his life, no matter all the events going on around him, we find him, one of his friends wrote it this way, that he often escaped to be alone and pray. Another time when people are clamoring for his attention, he actually withdrew into the mountains to steady and settle, remember all the things that are true, to rest alone with his father. And even to the very end of his life, they knew where to go to arrest him. Even in a clamoring, like hustling city of Jerusalem, he found a quiet place in the Garden of Gethsemane on the Mount of Olives to pray. They knew where to find him because it was a place he often returned to. How are we doing at returning to and resting in the things that will always be true? This way that Jesus invites us in the direction of peace to have a settled inner world just feels so backwards sometimes. Like when we lack something, generally we have like a whole skill set to go after those things. We try harder, we work harder, we work more hours, we develop a new skill or ability, we go get a new kind of education, all kinds of ways that we go after this. But after all the prioritizing and scheduling and striving, we seldom end up with peace on the other side. We sometimes are tempted to think that just on the other side of this job or this promotion, in the midst of this relationship or that purchase or this exercise routine or this health regimen, whatever it is, that somehow if we can just arrange circumstances right, we'll finally find peace. But it hasn't worked. It may provide relief for a time, but it seldom provides lasting peace. What Jesus shows us is a resting and returning to the things that will always be true, no matter our circumstance, no matter our striving. But there's good news. Peace is available. Peace is always available because God is always available. Jesus made sure of it. In fact, even when he was about to leave his friends, when he would give his life for all of us before conquering death on our behalf and sending his spirit to live in us, he said this to his friends. He said, "I'm leaving you with the gift, peace of mind and heart. And the peace I give is a gift the world cannot give." There's nowhere else to find this, Jesus says. So don't be troubled or afraid. I know so many things around us tell us we should be troubled or afraid, but Jesus says it doesn't have to be that way. We can live with a settled, peaceful, still spirit because of the things that are still true, no matter what's going on around us. Now, for those of us who have lived with Jesus for a while, we have experienced his presence and his peace. We know what he's talking about. He says, "Oh, I give you this gift. The Spirit will produce peace in you." The truth is, we get forgetful. We get busy, we get distracted, we get sidetracked. And so if you're a follower of Jesus, I just invite you again to return if this is a picture for you of this quiet, settled place somewhere in your inner world, to return to the quietness and stillness of all the things that are still true because of Jesus that we celebrate even at Christmas. To develop or return to some constant habits of making space for God to settle you in the midst of all that's going on around you. It's this kind of life that he's invited to. It's this kind of life that creates hope in us and a contagious hope into other people that there is better, that God has good in mind, that no messages around us or changes or developments or what might be ahead or what's just behind us could ever change. Settledness, a constantness. Let's live this way, followers of Jesus. For many who are watching alongside family members or finding your way here, you may not have ever experienced this kind of settled peace. Some success or provision along the way have given some relief and some good times for sure, but they're fleeting, or we're on the other side of this massive amount of striving or struggle, and you're just hustling, trying to stay ahead of the curve so that peace and quiet and happy can even be some kind of option. It doesn't have to always be that way. You don't have to chase. You don't have to strive. Or maybe for some, you've just fatigued. You kind of run out of steam, or there's been enough failure or enough loss recently, but there's a temptation to give up the hope of such a settledness, a peace, a confidence, a hope in the midst of so much challenge. But for all of you, I just want you to know, you can choose and experience peace and stillness by trusting what God has said about you in Jesus. It's the story of Christmas. He showed up to show you how valuable and worthy you are to be the one who would bring peace on earth. Maybe not always around us, but always in us. In a simple choice to trust, to believe and rest on the things that he says are true no matter what, will start to create a stillness and a peace about a place with him forever, his spirit alive in you now, his people around you, his word to show you his character, more and more things that you can rely on. You need only place your trust in him. Wherever you may find yourself, there is hope. If you would dare to place your hope in Jesus, he will show up with timeless truth to speak into your world that will create a foundation from which whatever may be shaky around you, you won't be shaken. Time after time, he'll speak a new and fresh word into you and your life by his spirit to create a settledness, a peace in an inner world that no change in money or circumstance or relationship or anything else around us could shake. A settled peace can be yours if you would place your hope confidently in Jesus and begin resting and living in his direction. If you would invite Jesus to create that kind of space, if you'd invite his presence to bring a calm, settled spirit in you, Jesus will show up. He'll be with you. He'll be for you. He'll surround you with his people. He'll fill you with his spirit, and you'll be able to navigate even a year like we've just had with a settled, steady, calm, confident hope. The God of hope will fill you with all joy and peace if you'll place your trust in him. For everyone who would trust in him, Jesus came to bring peace. His birth announced it, his life modeled it, his death paid for it, his resurrection guaranteed it, and his spirit makes it real in our lives when we trust him. While I love the mountains as a place to kind of reset, recalibrate, I actually love it way more as a picture of the things that are deeply true no matter what, the always true no matter what things that God has to say, which go way beyond whatever may be waiting for us in the valley. And this always ongoing kind of peace that lives and dwells in us is available to every single one of us who would accept this gift that Jesus gives to everyone who would dare to hope.